On the night of July 14th, 1956, another of Louis' dreams came true. He came home from his triumphs in Europe and Africa to play with the full symphony orchestra at the distinguished Guggenheim concert in New York's Lewisohn Stadium. Leonard Bernstein conducted the stadium symphony, made up of 88 members of the New York Philharmonic, in an arrangement of St. Louis Blues. Among the 25,000 in the audience was W.C. Handy, 83 and blind, who wrote the jazz classic of them all in a single night.
ladies and gentlemen, Louis Armstrong has told me that his most honored ambition is being fulfilled tonight in playing with the New York Philharmonic. I should say that it is rather we on the longer-haired side of the fence who are honored in that when we play the St. Louis Blues, we are only doing a blown-up imitation of what he does. And what he does is real and true and honest and simple and even noble. Every time this man puts his trumpet to his lips, even to practice three notes, he does it with his whole soul. This is a dedicated man, and we are honored.
I'd like to say thanks very much to Mr. Bornstein, and this first time playing with the Symphony Orchestra. And as we cats say, it gets me, man. It gets me. Thanks to Mr. Handy for being our guest this evening, because I've been playing his music for a long time. And thanks, ladies and gentlemen. I just don't know.
The question is constantly asked, what is the universal appeal of jazz?
One more.
How does this hot fusion of the Negro spiritual and the Creole folk song interlace with the basically sensuous rhythm of the tribal dance and the blue wail of the street funeral? How does this attract the French sophisticate and the Australian sheep herder and the Swiss watchmaker and a royal princess and an African chief? The theorist explains it as the dynamics of man's need for self-expression. Louis Armstrong says, if you have to have jazz explained to you, you'll never know. We'll be right back.